Hello friends, here we are going to discuss the Hindu newspaper of 16th of November 2017. So here this is the front page. Here in this front page, the private doctors in Bengaluru indefinite protest from today. You can avoid this news. And then this news is Zimbabwe military seizes power, says Mugabe is safe. So army claims it is targeting criminals around the president. Capital remains calm. So it looks like a military coup happens in Zimbabwe. So this news is regarding that. So what is all this about? We need to cover. Next important thing we need to cover, this BS-6th fuel. That is Bharat stage 6th fuel in Delhi from 2018. So here we should cover what is the difference between Bharat stage 4th and Bharat stage 6th, and why we have this skipped stage 5. That also we need to cover here is. And this another news, okay, here in this page front page there will be no important news here. So first we are going to cover this Zimbabwe's military says power, says Mugabe safe. So thing is that here you need to cover about mostly about the geography of Zimbabwe. That is important, especially for geography purpose. So here we are going to discuss. See, this is Zimbabwe sharing boundary with Zambia, Botswana, South Africa and Mozambique. Okay, so that we need to know. Zimbabwe sharing boundary with Mozambique, Botswana and South Africa and this Mozambique. One thing. Second is important kya hai? Major water bodies, yahan pe kaun kaun si hai, whichever the lakes are there. So these are the important. Victoria Lake is there and Lake Kariba is there. In Victoria Lake there is Victoria Falls is also there. And both on the western border with Zambia. Both are with the western border with Zambia. So here actually both are available. Here Lake Kariba and Victoria Falls. And so you can see here Lake Kariba and Victoria Falls here. This is Lake Kariba. Okay, this is Zambia. This is Zambia. This is Zambezi River. This is Zambezi River and this is Lake Kariba. And this is Victoria Falls and Victoria Lake here. Correct? It is Botswana. And this is South Africa. So important rivers kaun si hai? Limpopo River, that is making boundary here with South Africa. Another important river is your Save River is important. Runde River is important. And this one Zambezi River is important. So these are the some important rivers that is over there. Important river system is Zambezi, Limpopo, Runde and Save. So already we have covered. Okay, this is the Zambezi River is this. This is the Zambezi River. And this is Runde River, this is Limpopo River and this is Save River. So you need to also know for prelims purpose that Limpopo River is making the boundary between South Africa and Zimbabwe. Zambezi River is making boundary between Zimbabwe and Zambia. And Lake Kariba is also making boundary between these two. That is the important. And another important things we need to, there are any mountain, is there important mountain that we need to know here. Or kya padna hai there. And one more thing. It is near tropic of this Capricorn that is going from here. That also we need tropic of Capricorn. So it is over the near the tropics. So what is the vegetation says? So vegetations here are savanna grasslands. One vegetation that cover the southern reaches, while evergreen forest are common central and east, especially in the mountainous regions. That thing is that because it is very near, it is very, see, equator line, sorry, this tropic line passing through here, Tropic of Capricorn passing is through here. So after tropics here you will get savanna islands. So savanna islands found here, and here in northern east side you will this evergreen forest we can find. Now comes to what is the issue in Zimbabwe is going on. I mean, how did Zimbabwe come to in such an economic crisis? So friend, one, we need to know that $100 trillion, that is the largest currency ever issued, was in no other but the country once considered as bread and basket of Africa, that is Zimbabwe. Means $100 trillion ka one currency note has been released by Zimbabwe government because of inflation became so high. So for you can consider ki in our India largest domination currency is rupees 2000 note only, that's it. And see here, it is their reserve bank of Zimbabwe issued this $100 trillion because ki itna inflation ho gaya hai ki they are not, if they are paying $100, that is not going to buy sufficient thing, that is why they need to issue this note. So thing is that during 1980s, because we need to know Zimbabwe during this time Zimbabwe got independence. Right after its independence, annual inflation in Zimbabwe was 5.4%. only. And largest currency denomination was 20 Zimbabwe dollars. See, now 20 Zimbabwe dollar to 100 trillion dollar. And unemployment rate was 10.8%. That means agricultural was growing very good, and that is why it was considered as bread and basket of Africa. By 2008, actually annual inflation reached at 489 billion percent. Please, billion percent. Here in India, agar inflation rate increased to 20% even, then also lot of hue and cry happens, and the UPA government lost power only because of the double digit inflation was there. But we can see here annual inflation in Zimbabwe 489 billion percentage, and largest currency, because of that they need to issue 100 trillion dollar note, and unemployment rate shot up to 94%. Ki agar 100 people are willing to do job, then 94 people are not getting any job. So iska reason kya hai, what were the reason because of this issue? Reason is this: first is one of the worst dictators in the region, leading an extraordinary corrupt regime. Mugabe, Mugabe is still president of this Zimbabwe from the day of the independence. Okay, because of that regime become corrupt, means he has ruling Zimbabwe since last 37 years, and a terrible land distribution program that has demolished food productions. HIV and AIDS ripping through the regions, and public health is not good here. Second, Congo war happens, and Mugabe, that is, he was the president, or he is still president, he sent the army, and he, because of that, defense budget increased, social sector schemes budget reduced, and he has not mixed more concentration on agriculture. And because of that, his involvement in Congo war, again economy became in crisis. Then US sanctions to curtail Mugabe's regimes, and then regime's desperate effort to pull itself out of all this through printing money. So that was the issue happens. Now we can see here, population of Zimbabwe is 16.15 million. 16.15 million is the population. That means 1.61 crore. And GDP is 16.16 billion. And debt kitna hai? 13.6 billion. That means around 80% of that GDP ka to debt hi hai, and 76% of the rural households live on less than $1.25 a day. Means unke yahan poverty hai, that is 76% people are living below this. So that is the things we need to know. Now we are moving on another news, that is this BS4th fuel in Delhi, that BS6th Bharat Stage. So what is this Bharat Stage 6th that we can cover here is here is this news. Okay, so this news is this: green activist hails Bharat Stage 6th rollout. Okay, plan. So kya hai isme difference? Ki moving up to Bharat Stage 6 will lead to a significant reductions in the level of prime pollutant like particular matter 2.5, nitrogenous oxide, sulfur and carbon components. Because see, this is the Bharat Stage 4. Bharat Stage 4 mein sulfur content in diesel is 50 ppm. But Bharat Stage 6 mein sulfur content only 10. Reduce hua na. Carbon monoxide ka bhi. Okay. It and then nitrous oxides ka, this is also. So, kya difference are, what difference is coming? So, thing is this. Ki, CO emissions, that is our carbon monoxide emissions, are more evident. Okay, carbon mono emissions are more evident in petrol engines. Long term exposure, say what will be the impact? Long term exposure of this carbon monoxide emissions can prevent oxygen transfer and increase the headache, because ye jo hemoglobin hai, that can hemoglobin ko hata ke, it can going to means reduce the oxygen transfer. And another is hydrocarbon emissions are hydrocarbons, which are again more prevalent in petrol engines. Short-term exposures can cause headaches, vomiting and disorientations. And this nitrogen oxide emissions, which are more prevalent in diesel engine. Long-term exposure can cause nose and eye irritation and damage lung tissue. And particulate matter again is more prevalent in a diesel engine. Long-term exposure can harm the respiratory tract and reduce the lung function. So we need to know the impact of these pollutant. Now again come back, what will be the impact will happen on the four wheelers. So changes kya karna padega, changes in four wheelers. Bharat stage 6 emissions norms will require the installation of diesel particulate filter. Please remember this term, because if you are writing answer in regarding BS 4th or 5th or 6th issue, aapko ye wala term jarur yaad rakhna. You need to remember this term, diesel particulate filter. To remove particulate matters from the vehicle exhaust, it will need more space under the bonnet, correct? So that is the reason is extra expenditure need to be required. Another thing is BS6 norms will also require selective catalytic reduction technology. Please remember this technology, selective catalytic reduction technology, to cut down on nitrogen oxides in the exhaust. And this selective cut reduction technology uses ammonia, and this will need a national infrastructural upgrade to store and supply of ammonia. That we need to cover. So that is the reason is kya hoga ki vehicles ka jo vehicles price hoga, it automatically will increase. So that we need to know. So trend in particulate matter norms kya hai, even BS 1 tha, then particulate matter 0.36 hai, BS 6 mein 0.01 ho gaya hai. Emission standard yahan pe trend in nitrogen oxide mein dekho 8 tha earlier in BS 1 Bharat stage 1, now in Bharat stage it becomes 0.4. so vehicular emissions and the pollution due to the vehicular emissions will also reduce. Ye cheez aapko padhna hai. Now another editorial page mein we are going. So in editorial page, first is this, the last resort, it is a political article, we can leave this. Azuri Faddings, Indian football has hit its lowest point, that is also we can leave that. Ye jabs aise hi padh lo, but that is not also much important. Donald Trump's transactional diplomacy during his East Asia tour. Now comes to money cannot always buy votes. Ye thoda important nahi, but political science ke liye it is good. So why, what is this all about article is? This article is saying that ki there is widely held belief that voters in India, especially the poor, sell their votes in exchange for cash, liquor, saris and many other such goodies. Because we have seen in Tamil Nadu, and because they promise that they will give you saris, and in return of that they used to get votes. So there is a widely held belief that voters in India, especially poor, sell their votes in exchange for cash, liquor, saris, many other such goodies. Why is it a myth? Because cash flows during election not to buy votes, but rather to support a campaign. Jo bhi cash flow political particle candidates karte hain, they are not actually spending this much of amount to get votes, but they actually spend this much of cash just to support a campaign, just to advertise. Because we have seen so much large constituency hai. So in this large constituency mein, it is not possible if we are not spending lot of money in spreading this campaign, and that is the reason is they are spending money. Second is parties have weak organization at the local level, lack of committed volunteers to mobilize votes, that is why they need to spend cash. Then heavy institutional constraint hai ki only 14 days of official campaigning is required. So, and humongous size of constituency hai ki sirf 14 days hi diya jata hai, before that you cannot campaign, okay, you cannot spend money. So only 14 days official campaigning has been given, and in that days you need to spend lot of money to advertise your campaign. So the thing is that ki in this 14 days mein jo smaller honge candidates, those who are not having so much of money and muscle power, they cannot match those candidates, those who are getting lot of fund from political parties, as well as they are using their black money. Because if suppose this 14 days increase to 30 days, then smaller candidates will also will going to get time, then they are not going to have lot of money involved in this campaigning, and they can easily give tough fight to this. Since it is gap is 14 days, so those who are having money, they can easily campaign, and then they can get the vote, and smaller candidates are not able to fight against them. Then money is a symbol of power. Money actually signals resources and power, or access to powerful networks, correct? So someone who has no clout, means someone, those who have not monetary power bhi nahi hai, political power bhi nahi hai, familiar connection bhi nahi hai, is not actually seen by voters as the one who can work the levers of administration for them. Suppose lo, there are two candidates, candidate A and candidate B, both are fighting election. Candidate A is having muscle power, money power and political connection is also there. Candidate B is not having any of these. Then voters kya sochte hain? Voters think that candidate A, which is having lot of connection, if agar in future we require any administrative work, this person, that is candidate A with lot of network, can get work to done. But candidate B, since he is not having any connection, how he can do work even after winning the election? And that is the other reason is ki candidates actually, voters actually vote to these peoples who is having lot of connections. So to engage vote mobilizers or local individuals, party or candidate has to ensure them their minimum daily wage. Ki why actually lot of money is involved? Because to ensure the campaign, they need lot of volunteers, lot of party workers. A party workers, if going to campaign, then who is going to earn money for them? Because they are laborers. So kya karte hain ki these political particle candidates, they used to pay them at least minimum wage jo bhi unko earn hota hai. But again, it will, agar total amount will going to increase the expenditure limit, because expenditure limit 72 lakh rupees, you cannot spend more than 72 lakh rupees. So which would exceed the expenditure limit of the party, considering the worker to be engaged with a huge size of constituency. Thus, to avoid this, candidates spend huge sums of money on cash, liquor and gift that they hand out to their middlemen directly. Now solution kya hai? Solution is this: minimizing the size of constituencies. Means agar minimizing the size of constituency, it would require less efforts, hence feasible for the small candidates and parties. Second solution can be longer campaign period, means intensity of flow would be reduced and smaller candidate would get enough time to arrange the resources. Third is awareness regarding the value of voting power than city that city hold. Means we need to start a campaign awareness regarding the value of their voting power. Then big campaign required from civil society and voluntary organization to aware about right use of voting power. That is the only solution is. Now next is another, we are moving next page here. So here is this Tripura model. Human development consequences of peace in the state have been remarkable. So we need to know how Tripura is able to get. Since Tripura mein bhi pehle insurgency tha, Tripura was also facing in lot of insurgency, but still Tripura mein jo armed force special power act hai, that was removed, illiteracy rate improved, health condition improved, road connectivity improved. How it happens out of this insurgency? Aisa kya hua? So that we need to cover Tripura model. Here in Tripura model, we can cover here is this. Tripura Chief Minister Manik Sarkar. First, pehle pata kar lo Tripura Manik kaun hai Chief Minister. Tripura ka capital kya hai. Tripura is sharing boundary with which state. Tripura is sharing boundary with which international, means abroad state like Bangladesh. Aur kya denge Tripura mein, which are the mountain ranges there. Which is the river is passing through Tripura. That things we need to know for the geography. But please comment below you what is the capital of Tripura, Tripura is sharing boundary with which state, or Tripura's mountain ranges kaun sa hai, famous rivers of the Tripura, that also we need to know. Now Tripura Chief Minister Manik Sarkar has often said that economic and social investment and people's involvement. Kya hai? Economic and social investment and people's involvement are essential component of peace process in the state. So this line is very important. Economic and social investment and people's involvement are essential component of the peace process in the state. The landmark repeal of Armed Force Special Power Act in 2015 in the state was an outstanding symbol of success of its policy. Now you can consider the share of the literate persons above the age of 7 years rose from 73% to 87% between 2001 and to 2000. In 10 years itna increase ho gaya hai na. IMR, that is infant mortality rate, declined to 20 per thousand in 2015. See, national average of this infant mortality rate is 41, and Tripura ka kitna hai? Only 20 per thousand. That means if 1000 live birth hua hai, usme se 20 only actually child has been died. Infant means child whose age is under 1 year. Infrastructure, Tripura's rural rate connectivity is apparently one of the best in the country. Gender development, state has a sex ratio of 961 against all India average of 940. So our national average is 940, but is state ka kitna hai? 961. And one more thing we need to know ki Tripura comes under 6th schedule of this tribal area. So Constitution of India provided a special provision for the administration of Tripura under 6th schedule. And this autonomy also helped the state to maintain their diversity and grow as per the conditions of the local, be they forest dwellers or government servant. So ye bhi humko dikhna hai, these were the reasons because of that. So ye question aa sakta hai in mains exam ki why other states failed, okay, to actually to this get rid of this insurgency, but Tripura is able to do this. So aapko pata karna hai ki this economic and social environment, people's involvement lead to this get rid of insurgency in Tripura, or kya kya measures liye gaye, that on this please don't forget to means mention Tripura under 6th schedule also. This is important here. Is this is this is strangely forgotten. Ye hai uske bare mein ki we have so much history of this heroisms, but in our this educational curriculums we are not having any single chapters, okay, regarding these heroisms, especially this heroism at Rezangla. To despise such deficiencies from Nathula in 1962 to Kargil in 1999, the Indian soldier had remained stoic and steadfast in his commitment. Specific to 1962 war, there were many acts of gallantry of the highest order. और जो सबसे इम्पोर्टेंट था वो था रेजेंग लॉ इन इसमें रेजेंग लॉ इन द लद्दाख रीजन इसमें 13 कुमायूं एट रेजेंग लॉ इन लद्दाख रीजन ऑन नवंबर 18, 1962 गैलेंट्री इन बैटल कैन नॉट बी मीनिंग विल बी क्वांटिफाइड मच लेस कंपाउंड बट ऑड्स वर अगेंस्ट द 120 मैन लीड बाय मेजर सैतान सिंह इन ऑल बट 14 डाइड राइफल इन हैंड एंड बैटल पोजिशन एज चाइनीज ओवरवेलम देम. ये बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट स्टोरी है, प्लीज वी कैन नोट दैट स्टोरी. अदर क्या पढ़ना है, आफ्टर सुनामी की आफ्टर सुनामी जो इंडिया ने आफ्टर 2004 इंडिया हैज टेकन द लीड, इंडिया हैज हेल्प्ड एक्चुअली इंडिया हैज हेल्प द अदर नेबरिंग कंट्रीज इन दिस एफोर्ट इन दिस after devastation done by tsunami, India's image has been improved in this neighboring countries. So how the quiet took place after relief efforts in December 2004, that we need to cover. Ek ye hai rise of the boats, boats are shaping the internet today. To aapko pata karna hai ye science and tech GS paper 3rd ke liye this is important hai ki what are the boats are and how boats are shaping the internet today. Ye thoda explanation hai, we can cover this explanation also. So this is for today's the Hindu news analysis. Please like the video and comment below whatever you want, and your like actually is the motivation for me. Thank you.